Your word gives life to my dry bones. Your breath tells death they can ride on. Awake me, make me a living stone, a testament to your throne. I am nothing without you, I'm on my own. The only one who satisfies my soul.
What's that mean? Amen. Come on. Shh.
Yeah.
got a good video we show during our morning services. It really just gets our spirit ready. So hear this beautiful video on The Bible Says Who Jesus Is. Amen. Hallelujah. So God bless you and welcome to Living Faith. Let's play that video, Tommy. Praise the Lord.
The Bible says, my king is the king of the Jews. He's the king of Israel. He's the king of righteousness. He's the king of the ages. He's the king of heaven. He's the king of glory. He's the king of kings. And he's the Lord of lords. That's my king. I wonder, do you know him? My king is a sovereign king. No means of measure can define his limitless love. He's enduringly strong. He's entirely sincere. He's eternally steadfast. He's immortally graceful. He's imperially powerful. He's impartially merciful. Do you know him? He's the greatest phenomenon that has ever crossed the horizon of this world. He's God's son. He's a sinner's savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's unparalleled. He's unprecedented. He is the loftiest idea in literature. He's the highest personality in philosophy. He's the fundamental doctrine of true theology. He's the only one qualified to be an all-sufficient savior. I wonder if you know him today. He supplies strength for the weak. He's available for the tempted and the tried. He sympathizes and he saves. He strengthens and sustains. He guards and he guides. He heals the sick. He cleanses the lepers. He forgives sinners. He discharges debtors. He delivers the captive. He defends the feeble. He blesses the young. He serves the unfortunate. He regards the aged. He rewards the diligent. And he purifies the meek. I wonder if you know him. He's a key to knowledge. He's a wellspring of wisdom. He's a doorway of deliverance. He's a pathway of peace. He's a roadway of righteousness. He's a highway of holiness. He's a gateway of glory. Do you know him? Well, his life is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. And his yoke is easy. And his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you. He's indescribable. He's incomprehensible. He's invincible. He's irresistible. Well, you can't get him out of your mind. You see, you can't get him off of your head. You can't outlive him, and you can't live without him. Well, the Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they found out they couldn't stop him. Pilate couldn't find any fault in him. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him, and the grave couldn't hold him.
Come on, church. Hallelujah. Come on, let's all stand. Come on, let's give the King of Kings a great hand clap. Come on, someone say, that's my King. Say, King Jesus, he's my King. Tell your neighbor, do you know him? Praise the Lord. God is great and greatly to be praised. Welcome to Living Faith Family Worship Church, a church of love, a church of faith, a church that gives, and a church that reaches and preaches the living Word of God. God bless you as you've come to Living Faith to embrace the Word of God. Who is the Word? Jesus is the Word. Come on. His Spirit is here and His Spirit is reigning in this service. This whole month of August, we're talking about the anointing of God. This whole month of August, we're declaring we're going to receive answers. I want you to say with Pastor, I'm anointed. Come on. Say, I'm appointed. Come on, I'm anointed and I'm appointed. And in the name of Jesus, I'm going to receive my answers in Jesus' name. Let me read a verse of scripture before we begin with some praise. Psalm 20, verse 6. Now I know that the Lord saves the anointed. He will answer him from his holy sanctuary with his saving strength and his mighty right hand. Did you know God has an answer for you? Come on, somebody. Did you know His answer doesn't come from a man? It doesn't come from a woman. Come on. It doesn't come from your occupation. Come on. It comes from the throne room and the sanctuary of Almighty God. The Bible says, look above. All good and perfect gifts come from Him. So let's pray as we look up. Father, we look to You this day. This is the day the Lord has made, and we make a choice to rejoice in Your goodness, in Your love, in Your grace, and in Your mercy. So, Lord, we welcome the Holy Spirit to have His way in our services. We thank You, Lord, for what You've begun. You are so faithful in completing the work of the Holy Spirit in this church. Bless all the families that are here. Bless all the families that are on vacation or they're shopping because it's tax-free weekend. Praise the Lord. God bless everybody in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen and amen. Now give a great hand clap to our praise team. Amen. Stretch your hands towards the unit right there and declare, Lewis is blessed. He's working. And everybody else is blessed. And now declare, Benito bless. Marky bless. Sebastian bless. Carla bless. Eloy Jr. bless. Young Kayla bless. And everybody bless. Shake the person next to you and say, come on, let's have some church. Let's go, team. Praise the Lord.
I wanna scream it out from every mountain top. Your goodness knows no bounds. Your goodness never stops. Your mercy follows me. Your kindness fills my life. Your love amazes me.
And I sing because You are good, and I dance because You are good, and I shout because You are good. You're so good to me. And I sing because You are good, and I dance because You are good, and I shout.
Nothing and no one comes anywhere close to You. The earth and oceans deep only reflect Your truth. And in my darkest night, You shine as bright as day. Your love amazes me.
You are good, and I dance because You are good, and I shout because.
Come on,
you are
someone
good.
Say hallelujah.
You're so good to me. And I sing because You are good, and I dance because You are good, and I shout because You are good. You're so good to me.
My heart will proclaim that You are good. You are good. In the sun or rain, my life celebrates. And You are good. And You are good.
Do you believe He's a good God? Come on.
You are good.
Hey, hey, hey.
In the sun or rain, my life celebrates. You are good. You are good.
And I sing because You are good. And I dance because You are good. And I shout.
Come on, someone
you
say glory.
Good. You're so good
in the house of God.
And I sing because
You are good and I dance because you are good and I shout because you are good. You're so good to me. And I sing because you are good and I dance because you are good and I shout because you are good. You're so good to me. And I sing because you are good. You are good, I shout because you are good. You're so good.
Amen. Glory, clap, praise.
Church.
Amen.
It's a great blessing for you guys to be here. I want you guys to turn to your neighbor that says, you are blessed.
You're blessed. Amen.
Our brother Lewis, he's going to be with us today, but I know he's with us in the spirit, and he would definitely be up here singing with us. So without further ado, we have a new song to add to the collection. This is called All to Him. Stronger. for every battle that we face. He has conquered all, more than we can know. Our promise is Jesus, our answer is Jesus. All to him we owe. Our promise is Jesus. Our promise is Jesus. Our answer is Jesus. All to him we owe. Everything. Our Savior is Jesus. Our future is Jesus. All to him we owe.
Spirit of the Lord reign. Amen. Come on. Let the Spirit of the Lord reign in this place. Glory to God. Someone say the answer is Jesus. Come on. The answer is Jesus. Praise the Lord. The next time somebody comes up to you and says, I got a question. The answer is Jesus. Praise the Lord. Come on. We got these teachers up here praising the Lord. Give them a great hand clap. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Ken was telling me, look, Pastor Mark, we got so much representation on the stage, and what a blessing. Church, we're blessed. We have our children representation, amen. We have our young adult ministry representation, praise the Lord. We got our youth representation, come on. And we got the wise represented right here, praise the Lord, amen. God is great, and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Now listen, we're going to sing that how you did that, my Savior, glory, glory, you did that little mix. That's awesome. I like that. And we need to get the people just shaking and loving on each other. So go check on some people. Help pastor the church right now. Go love and go shake on somebody. We're going to sing that melody right now. And we're going to have a great, great, great time in the Holy Ghost. Go greet somebody right now in the love of the Lord. Tell them, welcome to church.
I give you glory,
glory. Jesus, our future is Jesus, Lord. give you the glory, glory. I give you the glory, glory. Jesus. Y te doy gloria, gloria. Y te doy gloria, gloria. Y te doy gloria, gloria.
Hermanos, digan amén, aleluya. Digan amén, aleluya. Come on, say amen, hallelujah. Come on, say hallelujah. Say it in English. Say it in Spanish. Say it in Japanese. Say it in Chinese. Say it with the Holy Ghost. That's right. Hallelujah and hallelujah. Listen, we're going to stir this atmosphere of faith. The answer is Jesus. There are some individuals right now being led of the Holy Ghost. There are some things right now you need answers. This whole month of the anointing of August, we've been talking about God releasing answers to you. You need an answer on a specific area in your life. I want you to make one line right here. The Holy Spirit has asked me to pray over you and to believe with you and to expect with you. So come right now, form one line right here. You're believing God for answers. You're believing God for an answer on something you've been believing, you've been expecting, you've been praying in the name of Jesus. Miss Kim, we're believing God for something. You stand in proxy of our family. We're believing God for something. Hallelujah. Listen, God wouldn't call you to church just to come and clap your hands and say hallelujah. God called you to church because He has an answer for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you know, our God is faithful. And our God is good. He's always good. He's always been good. He's always faithful. And He's always been faithful. There are some answers that we are seeking in our life. And the Bible says we have not because we ask not, or we ask amiss. Matthew 7 is the scripture being released in my spirit to you. The Bible says, ask, it shall be given. Seek, you will find. Knock, and the door will open. And so today, we're declaring with this anointing in this service, these answers to become very clear for our today and for our tomorrow. So if you're here right now, or maybe you're in your chair, or you're the hundreds that are listening online right now, I want you just to lift your hands right now, just like a funnel. And God is going to pour out His Spirit upon you. It's going to awaken some things in your life. Those answers that you need, you'll know in the name of Jesus. So I pray and I prophesy in the name of Jesus. I pray and I prophesy that by the anointing of the living God in this place, that we that have been seeking, we that have been asking, we that have been knocking, God is here to release that answer in the name of Jesus. I sense in my spirit one is desiring a direction that's going to make a complete change in everything you do. Listen, He's giving you the peace right now. While everyone else will be in turmoil, you will walk in the peace. While everyone else is questioning and wondering and wandering and asking why, you will have a peace. There's there's been a storm in someone's life. There's been a storm in someone's life. And God is now in the midst of your storm. And he's saying, peace, be still. Not only is he saying for the storm to be still, but he's also saying for you to be still and know that I am the Lord. There are some today that are comfortable in the boat, but God is on the water and he wants you to step out of your comfort and walk on the water. And I'm declaring today, you've dropped that oar, you've dropped that routine, and you have now stepped into the arena of faith with God himself. Holy Spirit, move afresh in their life right now. No pastor's not going to touch you. The Holy Spirit is moving upon you right now. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, come on, sense the genuine touch of the Holy Ghost. Maybe you're still in your chair and you need to be up here because there is some answers you need for someone else, or someone else needs a touch from God. Maybe it's a healing. Maybe it's a restoration. Whatever it is, God is here to do something. There's an aroma of faith in this place. And it's touching your life. It's rearranging some things in your normal walk. You're not going to talk the same. You're not going to act the same. You're not going to think the same. You are being changed and rearranged. Old things have passed away. New things are alive. Holy Spirit. And I'm declaring a fresh fire in your life. A fresh fire that will not burn out, but a fire that will keep the light on in your house. A fire that will keep you warm when you're cold. A fire that will show you where to go. Fire that will burn the things that are ungodly out of your life. God will wipe away the dross. He's purifying you. He's cleansing you. He's moving you. And I declare answers in the name of Jesus. You're looking and you're seeing on the television right now. You're on the internet and you're believing God for answers. There is an anointing in this place. And I declare that yoke destroying, burden removing anointing saturate us today. Holy Spirit. It's Sunday and it's worship. Come on, let's lift our hands and let's worship the Lord.
There's nothing worth more that would ever come close.
right now. I know it's a Sunday, but I'm being led of the Holy Ghost right now. You're being filled up to overflow. That's being lifted up to God right now among our worship. And the Lord is pleased. He said in the last days, Joel 2:22, He's going to pour out His Spirit among all flesh. He says your sons and your daughters, they're going to prophesy. The old will see dreams and visions, but the new will prophesy and speak life. Ezekiel, another prophet, was led in a valley of dry bones, and he needed an answer for the kingdom of God. God asked him a question. He said, will these bones live? And Ezekiel said, you know. And God said, speak to those bones. Listen, too many times we run from our mountains. We run from our Goliaths when God has given us the answer to stand and declare the victory. Come on. So many times we run away, but God is saying, come now and stay. Oh, saturate us with your Spirit this Sunday. Pastor, we normally prophesy and have an intimate time of worship on Wednesday. Get on with the service. It's a service led of the Holy Spirit. Someone is being refilled, recharged by the Holy Spirit right now. I say right now. Oh, you've questioned and you've asked why, but yet God is turning your whys and He's causing you to yield to His Spirit. I say yield. Yield doesn't mean stop. Yield means just slow things down a bit. Yield
does it mean close down? Yield means look at your surroundings. Father, you're in this place and you are releasing the answers. But Pastor, I don't feel nothing. Good. Add some faith. But Pastor, I'm really doubting. Well, God is giving you a challenge to prophesy and to speak life into that challenge. But Pastor, why this happened? Why that? Listen, just keep your eyes on the house. Keep your eyes on the Lord. Answers. Come on, lift your hands right now. Answers. Answers. Answers in the name of Jesus. You know, God's not going to give you all the facts. He's not going to give you the 1, 2, 3s, the ABCs. But you're going to know what door to open. You're going to know what to ask. You're going to know. When you find that, you're going to know it's from the Lord. I got a word of encouragement for you. And then we'll go back to our chairs. It's a story I heard when I was in Bible school. There were two boys, two young, vibrant boys, two challenging boys, two boys that love the outdoors. And they walked outside their house and they saw a lot of snow. They wanted to go out there and play. So they went out there and they played in the snow and they just had a ball outside. By the time you know, they were about a half a mile away from their house. And the boys, being very competitive, said, "Let's see who can make a straight line going all the way back home." And the young boy said, "Oh, that's easy. I'll do that. All I gotta do is look at my feet and walk right in front of my feet and occasionally look up to the house and make sure I'm back in line." And so the young boy said, "All right, ready, set, go." And he began to do it. He'd look at the house and he'd be walking, looking at his feet. He'd look at the house. Oh, he got off course. So he got a little bit back on track. Kept on going. The older brother, a little bit more wise, he saw his younger brother just doing what he was doing. The younger brother just looked at the house and he started to walk. He wasn't looking at his feet. He just looking at the house. By the end of the day, when they walked, the young boy said, "How'd you do it? How did you keep your line so straight? I was making sure my feet were right after the other. Yeah, I got off course a little, but I got back on course. And I just kept on looking at my feet." And the young boy said, "Because you were looking down when you should have been looking at the house." Come on. Come on. There's a time in our life when we look down. Oh, there's a time when we keep looking at the house and we let the Lord lead us and we just walk. Amen. Come on, love on each other right now. Love on each other right now. Tell each other, "We love you. We praying for you. I'm believing. I'm expecting." Let's sing one more song. Yes, Lord. God is great.
Come flood this place. Wasn't the praise team anointed this morning? Amen. Y'all may be seated. You know, the Holy Spirit is certainly moving this morning, and sometimes it's kind of hard to shift and make some announcements, but I know God is doing some things, and He's continuing to do things and moving His people, and we're just excited. You know, while we're in this atmosphere, I wanted to ask the church family to pray. I know a lot of y'all know Lucy, and she's having surgery tomorrow. She is fighting off cancer. Now, this cancer is not her cancer. There's a name greater than cancer, and that name is Jesus, and we call her healed. But we as a church family, I want us to stand together in agreement for her total and complete healing. We need a miracle, and we will have a miracle. And if she's watching, Lucy, we declare you healed in the name of Jesus. We are seeking some details. If any of y'all know, I asked her yesterday if she knew what hospital she was going to be in for surgery. She wasn't sure, but we want to keep her in prayer. We want her to know that she's loved. If you know her, Facebook her, message her, so she can probably check it later, but just love on her. And I want us all to just say, Lucy, you are healed in the name of Jesus. Amen. We call it done. We'll have a miracle to announce. Amen. Amen. I also wanted to make this quick announcement. On August 23rd, we're going to have our back-to-school anointing service. And we want all of y'all that can be here to be here. You know, I know this weekend's a busy weekend with shopping and all that, but if you can be with us, be with us. We have a lot of teachers in here, a lot of coaches in here, a lot of people who work for the school district, and of course all of our children. But we want to bless y'all. We want to give y'all some oil to take with you and put in your hands to anoint your classrooms. Be with us that day, because it's important to us that you go in to school not only mentally prepared but spiritually prepared. Amen. You know, Leah sent me a scripture this morning, and I don't know if all of y'all have her. Some of y'all do. If you're not, if you don't have her, she texts every morning a scripture. And this morning she sent me one, and I was like, you know what, it just touched me in a certain way. So let me read it to you. It comes out of 1 Peter 3. In starting in verse 12, it says, "For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to their prayer. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil. Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear their threats. Do not be afraid or frightened. But in your hearts be reserved. But in your hearts revere Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to answer to everyone who asks you to give a reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a clear conscience, so that those who speak maliciously against you, against your good behavior in Christ, they may be ashamed of their slander. For it is better, if it is God's will, to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteousness and for the unrighteousness, to bring you to God. He has put to death in the body. He was put to death in body, but made alive in the spirit." Amen. That is a beautiful scripture. And it just reminds us so much that God fights our battles for us. He's with us, even when it doesn't seem like He's with us. It says here that God's watching over us. He's protecting us. He's blessing us. But even when it seems like things aren't going right, He's still there and He still anoints us. He says, it says here, you don't have to defend yourself just because you have a clear conscience. People who defend themselves, it's because they have something to fight against. But when you don't have to fight, when people say things or you're concerned about things, it's because you know God is with us. So I encourage you to continue to stand your faith stand and love on Jesus and be who you are. And don't let anybody tell you any differently. No matter what comes your way, what tries to hit you, God is with you. You are God's people. Amen. Amen. Let me invite up all the children. It's time for class. Amen.
What a blessing and what a blessing. Well, summer is not over yet, but you know, everything is looking good. School is looking good. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for our children and our ministries and our teachers and the growing of the ministry in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we bless our children and we thank you for their life, their love, Lord, their legacy in you. Lord, we thank you for your teaching and your continual guidance and your hand upon them, for blessing them in the name of Jesus. And everyone said amen and amen. All right, well, they're ready to go. My, what a blessing. Come on, church, give them a great hand clap. Amen. Team, I'm going to dismiss y'all. Thank y'all so much. Praise the Lord, to go sit with the congregation. What a blessing it is to be in the house of God. What a blessing to be in the house of God. What a blessing it is to be in the house of God. Tell your neighbor, you're blessed. Come on, we're blessed coming in and we're blessed going out. Praise the Lord. I've received so many text messages. Pastor, we're watching online. Pastor, we're live streaming. Pastor, we're not there, but we're there in spirit. Pastor, my. Well, praise the Lord. Amen. You know, Tommy gave me the report that almost 70 people are viewing online at our morning service. Come on, to God be the glory. Amen. Wow. And till this day is just continuing to grow, and what a blessing. And we haven't done much advertisement about live stream, but the word is getting out and people all around the world are hearing the good news, the gospel of the Lord. This Living Faith Believing Church is a church that preaches and is a church that reaches. Amen. And for those that are viewing online around the world, God bless you as you tune in to our wonderful media ministry around the world. What a blessing. Come on, give them a great hand clap. Amen. They let them feel your love and let them know that you are praying with them. This month, August, we have been speaking about the anointing of God. You know, our first service was so anointed about how the Spirit of God is upon me. How the Spirit of God is upon me. And we began to read the scripture, Luke 4 and verse 18, how it's upon me to preach the gospel to the poor. To preach the gospel to the poor. And God revealed some things in that first service about we being the providers of the gospel of Jesus Christ to those that are in need, to those that need to hear, to those that need to change. And it's such a blessing to know that God has anointed us. God has appointed us. God has equipped us with all the tools to be a blessing. Amen. So this whole month, August, let's continue to believe for this anointing. Now, what happens in September? We're going to believe for more anointing. Amen. What about October? More. I mean, we're just climbing up. Amen. Glory to glory and from faith to faith. And so I keep on putting that in our spirits because one voice, amen. If you go, sir, what the pastor preach about the anointing? Well, I got to quit Jesus. Come on, somebody, amen. All right. So see, so one voice together, just being together, wrapped around his anointing. It's his anointing that destroys the yoke. It's his anointing that breaks the burdens. It's his anointing that keeps you going strong with him. Amen. It's the anointing of God that causes you to live for him. I got a report from Jesse and Sabrina. They were in Alvin there just yesterday ministering with ministers, and how they were at a men's advance, Pastor Kim, and they heard Living Faith minister the message of faith and hope and how they want to connect with the church. You know, the anointing of God causes you to reach. Amen. Causes you to reach. So we're believing God to continue to reach out to people, churches all around the world. Today I wanted to read and say a message that is going to bless you. I see the clock, and I put the title on, Tommy. It's titled, Old Me, New Me. Say, Old Me, New Me. Now, we're not talking about age. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because nobody is old in this house. Can I have an amen? Come on, say it in English. Say it in Spanish. Say it in Japanese. Japanese, right? We're happy. Praise the Lord. That just came out by the Holy Ghost. Amen. I meant to say Japanese, but I said Japanese. I'm so happy. I'm so happy that we're in the house of God. So happy we woke up today. We know the house of God is open. Amen. Praise the Lord. And many have called me and said they're out of town. Well, praise the Lord. We just thank the Lord for everybody. Amen. And to know there are hundreds viewing right now online. Listen, church, that so blesses us. So blesses us. And it's just a tremendous blessing. So I want us to go to Mark chapter 2. Mark chapter 2. You know, we've been studying the book of Mark now for almost 10 weeks now. And it's been a blessing to see the miracles in the book of Mark. Mark teaches in the gospel that Jesus is the miracle worker. And how miracles are assigned to you. And how miracles serve you. Mark's chapter opened up with Jesus calling his disciples, choosing his disciples. Someone say, I'm chosen. He was choosing his disciples, and he chose partners. He chose covenant. He chose brothers. They were out there working, doing what they needed to do to supply and support for their family. But God called them. He went a further. He went a little further, and he saw two more partners, brothers, James and John. And he said, come on, follow me. And they kept on following Christ. The first internship the disciples had was church. Come on, somebody. Amen. Jesus showed them there is power in corporate anointing. And while Jesus showed up to church, he stirred up some devils. Come on. In the house of God, devils were stirred. And devils approached Jesus and said, leave us alone. One bold devil went face to face with him and said, leave us alone. Why have you come? And Jesus cast that demonic force out, and a man was free. Come on. And the church was lit. Hallelujah. After that, then they go home to Peter's mother-in-law, to Peter's home, and his mother-in-law's there, and his mother-in-law is sick to the point of death with fever. You know, when does the enemy attack the hardest? Is when he attacks the family. When he tries to disturb the family, distract the family, derail the family. You see, when we say yes to Jesus, he knows our heart is tender. He knows that we're not completely in line with the Lord. So if he can do anything to throw us off track, he's going to do it. And when does he do it? He does it with the family. So here, Peter's mother-in-law, the family is sick. Here's his wife upset. Where were you? Here's my mama dying. You should have been here. They cried out to Jesus, and Jesus went immediately, and mama-in-law was healed. Amen. And see, that's a miracle for us and our family. If ever we're attacked in our family, know there's a miracle right around the corner. Know that there's promotion, and the enemy wants to blind us from seeing that promotion so we don't go forward. So mom-in-law's healed. And now as he serves, your miracle serves you. I'm not trying to find a miracle. Miracles find me. Mark 16 says, miracles, signs, and wonders follow those that believe. Someone say, I'm a believer. Therefore, you got miracles. Amen. Look behind and say, hello, miracle. Praise the Lord. Come on. Come on. Look to your side. Hello, miracle. Praise the Lord. Hello, miracle. Praise the Lord. Hello, miracles. Praise the Lord. I'm a believer. Come on. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That's a song, right? I'm a believer. I'm a believer. That's a song, right? I've heard it somewhere. Praise the Lord. We're believers, amen? We're believers. Eloy's teaching us a new song. Teach us that song, Eloy. We're a believer. Write a song, praise. Sebastian, write a song. Carla, write a song, praise the Lord. Miracles follow believers. Mark introduced us to these realms of faith as we began to believe God for miracles. Jesus went out praying early in the morning. The disciples were trying to find him because the house was filled up with more people that wanted more miracles. And when Peter found Jesus, he says, the house is filled up. And Jesus says, I can't go back. I got to go forward. So he kept on moving forward. And after city, miracles took place. Milagros. In every city, crowds of people were following Jesus. He was in a house teaching, and the crowd was there. And four people came with a lame man on a stretcher, seeing, hearing, believing, expecting their friend to be healed. They couldn't see Christ. Christ couldn't see them. It didn't stop them. They climbed the roof. They undid the roof and they lowered him. And Christ said, son, your sin is forgiven. The religious people were upset. They said, blasphemy. Who are you? You're not God. Only God can forgive sin, not man. But Jesus knew in their heart of them judging him. He said, I've come to show you that I'm able to heal the sick, and I'm here to also bring you close to God in your spirit. And then he said, get up and walk. And this boy got up and he walked, and everyone marveled and everyone began to follow Christ. He wakes up the next morning and he says, today I'm going to choose another living faith believer. Come on, somebody. Today I'm going to Cthulhu. Today I'm being around the world with lives. Today I'm preaching and I'm reaching around the world. And I'm going to choose a disciple. Now the first choosing were simple Jews. Simple jobs. Working in their field. Staying busy to support and supply for their family. Simple. Uneducated. Hard workers, calloused hands, work with the sweat of their brow, good at what they did, honest people, hard workers, family oriented, keeping themselves in covenant and in partnership with each other, being equal to one another. That was the first group. This individual was a different catch. Come on. This individual, when Christ walked up to him, he was at a tax booth collecting money. And his reputation wasn't popular in the city. He was considered a traitor, a thief. Hypocrite, a backstabber, a thief. He wasn't popular at all, only among his own friends. But Jesus, as we preached on Wednesday, had his sight on a sinner. Come on, somebody. He had his sight on a sinner. And he saw this Levi at a tax booth. And he said to him, "Follow me. Follow me." And at that very moment, he dropped what he was doing and he followed Christ. This Levi, Matthew, could have been the first evangelist ever recorded. The moment he got up and he followed Christ, he was on his phone, texting all his sinning friends, "I'm following Christ." Come on. He put it on blast on Facebook and he says, "I don't care what people say about me. I'm following Christ." Come on, somebody. His reputation had already been messed up with what he was doing. And in a moment's time, his past became the platform for his present to preach the power of God. My goodness. God didn't look at him at what he was doing or what he did. God saw what he was fixing to do. This individual who was a sinner got on the phone and he called all his sinning friends and he says, "Come to my house. I'm cooking a meal." And Christ sat, the Bible says, with sinners and tax collectors. His disciples were there. In a distance were the Pharisees and the Sadducees and all the scribes, the religion. And they began to mock and ridicule and ask questions and say, "Who does this man think he is? He sits and he eats with sinners. I thought he was a man of God. How can he be clean, sit with unclean people?" And his disciples were questioned. Jesus answered for his disciples. Someone say, "Jesus got my back." Come on, somebody. "Jesus talks for me." Come on, somebody. Pastor Kim said, "You don't have to defend Jesus Christ, your defense." Come on, hallelujah. You see, and Jesus heard them talking to his disciples while he was in the midst of sinners. And Christ said, "I didn't come for those that are healed. They don't need a physician. But to those that are sick, they are seeking a savior." And Christ opened up the door. So from one sinner became a sea of sinners and no longer sinning people, but now following fervently the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. God did something in their life. So they had a feast. They were feasting. And religion was upset. The Pharisees, scribes, critics, they were upset. "How can you feast today when you're supposed to be fasting?" See, the Jews, really, they were only supposed to fast in September on the Day of Atonement. But religion added all these other rules. And they said, "No, we also fast on Mondays and we also fast on Thursdays. And we let the whole world know that we are fasting." So the religion said, "How can you be feasting when you should be fasting?" Let's read the scripture now, as you can turn in your Bibles or you can look at the screen, where it says here in Mark chapter 2, starting with verse 18. "The disciples of John and the Pharisees were fasting. Then they came and said to him, 'Why do the disciples of John and of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast. Jesus is being questioned right now. Jesus said to them, can the friends of the bridegroom fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast in those days. No one sews a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, or else the new piece pulls away when it is washed, and it will tear the old, and it will be made worse. And no one can put new wine into old wine skins, or else the new wine bursts, and the wine skin breaks, and the wine is spilled. And the wine skin will be ruined, and the wine also ruined. But you put new wine into new wine skin. Jesus is being questioned about fasting. You see, he was feasting. Come on. He was in celebration. Come on. He's getting promoted. Come on. He's walking in the favor of God. Come on. He's being blessed, right? And he's being blessed. He's being blessed wherever he goes. And he's feasting. He's celebrating. Souls that were lost are now found and following Christ. Come on. It's a time of celebration. Amen. I was lost, but now I'm found. I'm celebrating. I was blind, but now I'm healed. I'm celebrating. God gave you an answer. Celebrate. Amen. God gave you a miracle. Celebrate. God did something for you in your life. Celebrate. Jesus was celebrating. His sight was no longer on a sinner or a sea of sinners. His sight was now on followers of Jesus Christ. But religion on the side of the road, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the scribes, they still saw the sinner. They still saw the faults. They still saw the past. Come on. They still judged by the past. They still worked by the law. They still did all that they needed to do by their works of righteousness. Failed to see the grace of love. Christ was celebrating. So Christ used three parables or three analogies. He spoke of the bridegroom. He said, you know the law. When one is getting married and everyone that's participating in that marriage, you don't have to fast that week. It's a week of celebration. Covenant union is fixing to take place. Two becoming one is taking place. Come on. There's a blessing in the making. Come on. So we're celebrating this full week. So Christ gives that analogy or that demonstration to the Pharisees, and he says, the bridegroom is here. Those that are with him can't fast. But when the bridegroom leaves, after the bridegroom gets married and leaves, then the host and the people, then they go back to their fasting. But right now, while he's here, celebrate. Come on, somebody. Amen. And see, they couldn't see that. They couldn't see. They saw him sitting with sinners. They saw him sitting with tax collectors. They couldn't see the hope. They couldn't see the victory. They couldn't see the celebration. So now they poke Jesus. And now they say, well, here's the disciples of John. Here are the disciples of the Pharisees. And we fast, but y'all are feasting. Something doesn't go. That doesn't look right. How can you minister? How can you proclaim you're a disciple? How can you declare you're a believer if you're not doing what the law says to do? So then he says, you don't sew a new piece on old clothes. Because when you wash that cloth, that sewn piece is going to shrink. And it's grabbing on to what's torn. And when it shrinks, it pulls. And now it's torn again, and it's torn over there. And now you can't use it no more. Jesus is saying, you can't think the way you always think. You have to open up your mind to the realm of grace and love. Then he brings another analogy. And he says to them, you can't put new wine in old wineskin. Because the new wine ferments. Ferments. It gets fermented. It stretches. It expands. And that old wineskin cannot hold it. So it breaks. What happens? The jar breaks, and now the wine is spilled. Now you have no jar and you have no wine. So you can't put new in the old. What Jesus was saying was, all your life, you've been patching your walk. All your life, you've been trying the new, but you're still in the old. Come on. Why doesn't God bless me? Why doesn't God? Why? Because you're still in the old. But today, God wants to put a brand new garment on you. Come on. Quiere poner una nueva de estilo, traje, de quiere cover, cubrir, con un saco de amor, amén, con un saco de gozo, aleluya, con un saco de poder, de prosperidad, aleluya, come on. Un saco del Espíritu Santo, aleluya. Un saco de fuego, aleluya. Come on. But I gotta get out of the old, come on. I gotta get the stinking thinking out of my mind, come on. I can't be blessed thinking I'm poor. I can't be found thinking I'm lost, come on. I can't be new if I don't accept the new. So everything changes. Everything changes. They're asking, wait a minute. We've been fasting Mondays and Thursdays every day, every week. And here you're telling me this. He's not telling you not to fast on a Monday nor a Thursday. Continue. But stop adding patches to your life. And start adding the power to your life. Those patches, they're going to come off. Come on. How many of you ever patched a lawnmower tire before? Or you've had it repaired? Eventually, you're going to have to patch it up again. Patch it up again. Patch it up again. Patch it up again. How many had an old lawnmower and you bought a new starter for it? And then that starter goes out and then the solenoid. And you buy a new solenoid and then the plug is. And then, still lawnmower. What do you want? Yo quiero una nueva. Y quiero una con warranty. Amen? Que pro John Deere. Hallelujah. Amen. Call it in the name of Jesus. Amen. No quiero ando Get around. I want a new one. Amen. Come on. Now, Danny and Josie just got a brand new car. They blessed. Highly flavored of the Lord. Praise the Lord. They came to the house and said, Pastor, bless it. I said, Amen. And he said, give me the keys. I said, drive it and bless it. Okay, let's go, Daddy. Come on. I stepped into that car. I went like this. There's none like new car smell. Amen. I got into my old pickup truck. I go buy a freshener, new car. Then the Lord reminds me it's paid for. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can smell, baby. It's all right. You're paid for. Hallelujah. Oh, blue. My son Caleb and Marcus said, Dad, when I'm a teenager, I'm going to drive to school, right? And you're going to get me one of those big trucks with the big tires. And said, you're going to drive old blue. Old blue? He then said, it's going to be dead blue by the time I drive. And I said, you know what? For that, you're going to walk to school because we just live right here. Y corre porque hay perros. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Put the message back on, Tommy. Old, out with the old, in with the new. Out with the old, in with the new. Old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come alive. I'm a new creation in Christ Jesus. Old things have passed away. New things have come alive. My old thinking is old. I can't put new wine in old wineskin. And you know, it's challenging for change. It's challenging sometimes to accept something new. But do you know what these Pharisees, Sadducees, you know what religion was doing? They were just patching on to life. God never told them to fast on Monday and Tuesday. They patched that on as a law. So now they're walking a patched life when God has called them to put on a new garment. Come on. The old is not about how old you are. Amen. Someone say praise the Lord. Because your spirit, there's no baby spirit, and there's no senior spirit. One spirit. And that same spirit that rose Christ from the dead dwells in Chris and Jessica's baby. Help me with Elaine, beautiful Elaine, red hair, beautiful. That same spirit that rose Christ from the dead dwells in her is the same spirit that dwells in me. Smith Wigglesworth was about this tall, about 4'4". How tall are you, Kim? He's about 4'4". He walked into a train one day and 30 people fell out in the Spirit of God. He just walked in. Little man. God doesn't see your outer appearance and how big you are, how little you are. God sees what you're carrying, and we're carrying His Spirit. We can't carry the new if we're dressed in the old. You know, our children are going to school here in a couple of weeks. Praise the Lord. The teachers have been very busy this month of August. And we're praying for our teachers and coaches and faculties and administration and custodians and food services and transportation, everybody. And normally, you know, families go shopping and they go buy new clothes for them to start their new year. Because there's something about new that makes you feel valuable. Amen. You might say, well, Pastor, I don't need nothing. I'm fine the way I am. I don't need nothing new. But if new was presented to you, come on, you'd take it. You'd take it. New was being presented to these religious people. They were upset. Remember, what is Jesus doing feasting? He ought to be fasting. Come on. Criticizing and judging, not seeing the sea of followers, but yet still seeing law, works, sinners. God changes and turns all that around. He says, the day's coming where I'm going to be gone and my disciples will fast. Come on. They will do as the Spirit leads them. Pastor, what's fasting? Fasting is depending on God. It's saying to yourself, self, you're not in control. God is in control. I challenge you, if you're seeking an answer, or you need an answer, I know we prayed. I challenge you to put self aside. In other words, desires, your routine of life, and focus on Him and fast. Not because you're told to do it, come on, but because you need to do it. Because I want to do it. You see, these individuals did it because that was a patch of law that I had to do. Wasn't really doing it because they were seeking something. Or at least not from God. They did it because they had to. And these disciples were growing in the grace of God. God was teaching them. I'm not going to show you how to patch some things. I'm going to teach you how to become new things. Come on, somebody. To God be the glory. Thank you, Jesus. There are angels in this place. I sense the angelic presence, very reverent. Because the Lord is changing some things. Amen. No more old me, new me. Come on. No more old me, new me. Now you're saying, well, Pastor, I left my old a long time ago. Every day we can grow. Every day we have a chance to do something to bring the newness of God's light into our life. Let me pray over you. Father, you said in your word that we're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a peculiar people, your own special people. Lord, you have chosen us. To do and to be all that you have for us. This day, I declare a new in the name of Jesus. This day, I declare a new in the name of Jesus. A new joy, a new faith, a new realm of love, a new garment of praise, a new love. Sight here, I declare a new in the name of Jesus. Scripture. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away that stony heart. And I will give you a heart that is real. A heart that is of flesh. So that's, Ezekiel was a prophet. And God spoke to him as he spoke to the children of Israel. We're flying the Israel flag. We're flying the Star of David out there in the property if you haven't seen it. Because we're declaring a new for our Jews. God's holy people. And we're declaring the new for us. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart. I'll take it out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart that is flesh, that is real, that is tender, that is moving. That's my prayer. God, make me. God, break me. God, build me. God, use me. God, create in me the new. Come on, somebody. Come on. The new. Amen. The new. I declare the new in the name of Jesus. I declare the new in the name of Jesus. No more patching my life. No more adding law to my life. I am new in God's grace, new in His love, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you this. Christ was for the law. God gave the law. But God made it simple. And man added patches to it. He kept on adding and adding and adding and adding, and it got confusing. And the people who once saw Almighty God as their shepherd were so confused with these patches of life. They no longer saw God. They saw routine. I wrote something I want to tell you, and then we'll dismiss. Christianity is not a ritual routine. Christianity is knowing, growing in the grace and in the love of God. When you grow in the grace and the love of God, The law is there. Come on. Thou shalt not, come on, worship any other god. The law is there. Thou shalt not. The law is there. It keeps us in line. But it's all these other little patches that brought confusion. And that's exactly what the enemy wanted to do. And he did. Someone say, but Jesus. That's right. But Jesus came and he rearranged. Amen. Someone say the new. Come on. Say, I'm the new. Amen. The old man's old and the new man's new. Praise the Lord. Old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come alive. Give the Lord a great hand clap. Praise the Lord. What a blessing. What a blessing it was to minister this passage on Mark chapter 2, 18 through 22 on fasting. God bless everybody as you listened to this wonderful, wonderful message. Amen and amen. Let's receive a tithe and an offering for the work of the Lord and the ministry of the kingdom of God. Praise team, come on up as we prepare to sing a song of just love and dedication. Amen. Lift your hands for an offering envelope for the record of your giving. For those that are viewing online, you can also go to our church website there and you can donate and you can sow a seed online. And you can go and follow all the instructions and you'll be emailed an immediate response and receipt and all that. So what a blessing it is. And thank you, thank you, thank you for sowing. Thank you for believing. And thank you for continuing to trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Grab your seed, or if you haven't put it in the offering container yet, just grab it and declare it blessed. I call this seed blessed. I call this tithe blessed. I call in the name of Jesus, oh, just the blessings of the Lord. Many of you, I had a brother come to church today and he says, I'm believing for healing in this person's life, and I have an offering to sow a seed. This individual knows the power of the seed. And he knows that seeds will meet needs. And you got to aim your seed. Remember, we don't just throw it. Come on. Because if you throw it, then the birds of the air are going to go and pick up your seeds, and they're going to take it somewhere else. But if you dig a little bit, come on, and you sow it, come on, and you declare faith, believe, and expect, that seed's going to grow, and you're going to believe, and you're going to know that where you sowed, you're going to also reap. Amen. So be faithful with your tithe, be faithful with your offering, and be faithful to the Lord. Let's all stand, amen. Let's stand in faith. Let's believe in faith. And let's sow in faith. God bless you. Come on, team. Let's sing a song of victory.
And what if you turn into wine? And open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. And none like you. And into the darkness you shine.
stretch your hands right now to these offering baskets. Lord, we lift up these baskets of faith to you, these containers. Lord, we know that as we have sown, we know you see. And Lord, we know that yes, there is a harvest. But most, Lord, we sow because we love you. And we love the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. So Lord, put to work this seed as it continues to grow in Jesus' name. And everyone said amen. And amen. Come on, a great hand clap to the Lord of Lords. Amen. Praise the Lord. God is great and greatly to be praised. Now, I know we had some people missing today, but love on them. Call them, check on them, tell them we missed you. And I know there were hundreds watching online. What a blessing and what a blessing. Wednesday, 7 o'clock, to God be the glory. And we'll see you with us. If this was your first time, we want you to continue to come. Amen. And be blessed. Now, Mr. Pilar Martinez is here. He was believing God for prayer. And we're going to stand with him and believe with him for Lucy Martinez, who's having surgery this week. We're continuing to pray for Lucy, and we're believing God for healing and restoration. Eva's here. Her son, David, is also having surgery this week. And we're believing God for healing in the name of Jesus. Danny's mama had surgery and is back, and she's strong and she's doing well. My father had surgery in his eye. He got 20/20, and he's doing great. Tiene ojo de águila. Praise the Lord. Sister Elia tiene ojo de águila. Praise the Lord. She's doing great. Amen. Who else needs a healing in their body? Come on. Lift your hands and say, I'm healed. Come on. Who else needs a miracle? Come on. Say, I believe and I receive in the name of Jesus. So I challenge you this month of August, declare the anointing and declare answers. And God is with you. We'll see you Wednesday. God bless you, church. We love you. Have a blessed afternoon.
Stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance. Yeah.